Good day, everybody. Welcome back. In the previous lecture, we already looked at the forces acting on the rudder, why it is getting acted, and you saw that there is high pressure is getting created and low pressure is getting created this side. Please go through the previous lecture, then you will understand why this is happening. So in this lecture, we are going to look at the components of these forces, so what we have done here is that I have divided, this is the rudder force which is getting created because of the high and low pressure difference. So this is the rudder force or the resultant force. This resultant force is divided into two components, one like this and the other one like this. So this resultant force is divided into two components, one like this and the other one like this, right? So I will draw this one in a different piece of paper. So in a different piece of paper I will be drawing this one, and let's say this is the ship heading and this is the rudder. Here we have put again starboard rudder angle, right, where you can see there is a rudder force is getting created. This is rudder force and there are, we divided this rudder force into two components. Now if we are going to name these two components, before we name this, we will go to the aircraft industry. In the aircraft industry, if you look at the cross section of this rudder, it looks like an aircraft wing. So aircraft wing is something like this, right? Not exactly same as the rudder shape, but something like this, a similar shape, right? In the aircraft wing, so this is an aircraft, this is an aircraft which is moving this direction. When it is moving this direction, there will be a flow of air like this, and there will be high pressure and low pressure getting created. There will be high pressure here, there will be a low pressure here, and there will be a force getting created upwards, and another force is getting created this direction. So this upward force is called the lift of the wing, and this force which is against the motion is called the drag force. So this, because of this lift only, the aircraft is going up, right? So the wing is getting this lift force, this aircraft is going up. Now we put the same words over here. You can see this rudder is also looks like a cross section of the aircraft wing, right? So we have borrowed this name. So this component is going to be the rudder lift. Now in this case, nothing is getting lifted up, but we are just only borrowing it from the aircraft industry, right? So this is the rudder drag force, right? So now the most important force here is this rudder lift force compared to this one, because this is what determines efficiency of the rudder. As this is higher, the rudder efficiency is high, and this is, if this is high, that means the rudder efficiency as well as the ship's motion will be getting affected by this, because this is against the motion of the ship. So this is basically a resistance where a fuel consumption will go high. Whatever the force will increase the fuel consumption is a resistance to the ship's motion. So this is a resistance to the ship motion, right? But this resistance has nothing to do with the surface resistance, right? This was created by the pressure difference. This was created by the pressure difference or the foam. Foam drag, right? This is because of the shape of the rudder. So this is a kind of a foam drag. Furthermore, we will furthermore about the foam drag, we will be discussing in a later lesson what is this foam drag, which is also called viscous pressure drag, but we'll be looking at that one later on, right? So the lift force is the one which is basically going to turn the ship, right? So the lift force is getting created when the rudder angle is given. Now let's calculate this lift, right? Let's calculate this one. So now we have to introduce something called a coefficient of lift, right? Lift coefficient. Now there are lift coefficient, when you are learning about ships, there are so many coefficients you have to learn. There are block coefficient, water plane area coefficient, prismatic coefficient. Likewise, there are several coefficients. So this is also a coefficient. So we have to introduce a coefficient of lift, right? So this coefficient of lift can be given by this formula, and that formula is that if you look very if you look at this force, the maximum force that can occur, let's assume that the kinetic energy is coming in this direction, that the kinetic energy is coming. But what if the kinetic energy is coming like this? This is the maximum force that the rudder can experience. If the kinetic, assume that the flow is coming like this, just assume, not like this, not actually this is coming like this, but assume that it is, the flow is coming like this, just assumption only, right? In this case, this is a maximum force that will be acting on the rudder. So we can see that this force is the kinetic energy, which can be given by half rho v squared, velocity of the ship itself, right? But this is for a unit area only, half rho v squared. If you if you are not familiar with this kinetic energy, please go to the previous lectures. Everything is explained, right? So half rho, this is the density of the liquid, and the velocity of the ship itself. So half rho v squared is for the unit area. Now if we need the whole area, what is the force acting on the whole area? This is for the unit area. So for the whole area, we have to multiply it by area of the rudder. So when we multiply it by the area of the rudder, we can find out the whole maximum force that it can experience compared to the actual force, which is acting as a rudder lift, right? So the coefficient is basically the ratio of the maximum force to the actual force, right? So this is the maximum force, this is the actual force, right? You will see later on there are so many similar formulas coming, especially in windage, the same, most of the formulas having a similarity. You will see that later on, right? So this is rudder lift, is basically the coefficient of the lift is basically the ratio between the actual force compared to the maximum force. So right, so this is one of the major coefficient when it comes to the rudder. For example, this is the ship's rudder. Now if you want to do a research about this ship's rudder, you cannot create a so massive big ship's rudder. Instead, you are creating a model rudder, a small one, and you'll be putting it inside into a towing tank or a cavitation tunnel or whatever it is. You can create a small model, right, which totally resembles a scale model, which totally resembles the bigger model. So from this model, you can find out the coefficient of lift. From the by using this coefficient of lift, you can predict what will happen in the actual big rudder, what will happen in the actual ship's rudder. So this coefficient of lift you can even find out in a model basing, right? So anyway, now this is one of the the one of the major coefficient when it comes to the rudder, because the efficiency is depending on rudder efficiency is depending on this value, correct? So now what if I put these ones into this side, it will become the rudder actual rudder lift equals to half coefficient of lift and the area of the rudder and the velocity squared of the flow. Actually this is called the propeller slip stream, because of probably somewhere here, right? So this is a slip stream where the water is coming. This velocity is given by the given by this this V, not the ship speed exactly. Previously I said this is the ship speed just for the explanation, but this is not exactly the ship speed, this is the propeller wash speed. So there will be a difference between the ship speed and the propeller slip stream, right? Because this can when we give an accelerated turn, you will see later on what is this accelerated turn, we will increase in the propeller RPM, right? But the ship speed is not going to increase immediately. But the, when the propeller RPM is getting increased, the water flow will increase. But that doesn't mean that the ship is going to immediately increase its acceleration like a car, right? But the propeller flow, the water flow will increase, the speed of the flow. So this speed is representing the flow around the rudder itself, right? So now the actual rudder lift, you can see it is proportionate to the velocity of the rudder, of the water flow around the rudder, and squared of it, right? So if you change immediately, let's assume that if you increase the RPM by a small amount, right, this flow increases and the whole value will go up by a squared amount. That means the rudder lift increases rapidly by a small change of the velocity of the flow. This velocity of the flow can be increased by the propeller itself. That is, this is what is called the accelerated turn, right? So this is why the accelerated turn is happening. How it is happening is that, let's assume you have to take a tight corner when you're moving in a channel or something. Let's assume that you have to take a tight corner. Let's say this is a tight corner where you have to turn the ship towards this side. So what the pilots or the master, what they will do is they will approach in a smaller velocity on at a small speed, but they will give first, they are giving rudder harder starboard, and they increase the RPM immediately. They increase the RPM immediately, so you can see velocity increases and it is going up in the squared value. The lift force increases rapidly. It increases rapidly. That doesn't mean that the ship is going to gain momentum. It will not gain momentum. Instead, what it will do is it will immediately turn. The ship will immediately turn. So this is called accelerated turn. This is called accelerated turn. So you can see that why it is happening. The reason is because of this, because you are not changing the rudder. Rudder area is not going to change because the coefficient of the lift is not going to change. So the velocity increases and it goes up in the squared value, and immediately the rudder lift, without gaining a momentum, forward momentum of the ship, instead you will be getting a higher turning force. So the ship will immediately turn in this corner. So this is called accelerated turn. Okay. So now we will look at. So now we will look at the drag force. Right. The drag force, in the drag force, you can see basically drag force is nothing but a resistance to the ship's forward movement. This is just a resistance only. So this will be reduce as much as possible by the shape of the rudder, so and by the smoothness of the rudder, as well as other factors. There are different research going on to reduce this one, right? So anyway, you can see that it is just a resistance only, nothing else. It does not provide any assistance for the turning of the ship. Only the rudder lift is providing assistance for the turning of the ship. So efficiency of the rudder is depending on this force only. So you can see that if you increase the area, also the area of the rudder itself also increases the rudder lift, right? But there is another resistance. If you increase the area, there is another resistant type acting. So one resistant is the rudder drag created by the pressure difference, right, which is called the foam drag. But there is another resistant also, which is basically the frictional drag. Friction of the rudder itself, also another feature acting against the ship's motion. So two types of resistances are there. One is the frictional drag, other one is the rudder drag, or the viscous pressure drag, or foam drag. This I would rather say foam drag, right? Because of the shape of this rudder, this drag is occurring, and this is because of the friction of the surface, right? So there are, so increasing of the area is, again, even though it will increase the rudder lift, even though it is going to increase the rudder lift, but there is a drawback here. You can see that the friction is increasing, so that is a drawback, right? So later on you will see there are certain aspect ratios maintained in the rudder, right? You are not going to put the ships are not getting put bigger rudders or smaller rudders, so there is a nice ratio how to determine the area of the rudder, right? So we will look at that one later on when it comes to the construction of the rudder. So thank you very much. We'll in the next lecture we will look much more details about these forces.